because I want to just celebrate a couple of things here. First of all, EMS and the heroic team that they represent and all the work that they do at a moment's notice. And never knowing just what the situation might be. We've learned to solely depend on our EMS team as, for all that they are. But today we have somebody from the community, and Vince Southern, Mr. Southern, for just, you know, you are not only a hero, you're the epitome of a hero in what you've done, saving this young man. And I happen to believe personally that when something like that happens, we should celebrate it, we should share it with the community. This was a very incredible effort on your part. And so on behalf of all the people in this community who appreciate your heroism and so happy that you're safe, I want to say thank you on behalf of all those thousands of people who live here, appreciate people like you. But I really want Dr. Jim Arnold to come up here and take over this, because I really do think this is an EMS moment, if you will.
Thank you, Mayor. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. Thank you, Mr. Southern, for coming. Appreciate that. I'm going to take my mask off here. I'm going to have some lines on my face. But Monday, as you all know, there was a weather alert, and we had very, very heavy rains, and creeks and streams and canals that are normally quite docile became raging torrents. And a little after 4 o'clock, we received a call at the Joint Traffic Management Center, the Communications Center for the city, that two boys were swept away in a canal in Waipahu. And that's, you know, whenever there's an emergency call, everybody obviously pays attention to that and reacts to that. But when we hear it's children, it just makes it that much more serious, because many of us have children or have children in our families or no children, and it really is just a different type of call. And so the Honolulu Fire Department and their rescue services, along with EMS and the police department, all responded. And two children were in the water. Mr. Southern had heard the cries for help, retrieved a rope from his truck, and was able to fasten a lasso-type device to pull this young man out of the water and save him. When EMS arrived, they treated his injuries, they took care of him, and took him to the hospital. Later, the police discovered the other boy had made it out on his own and back home, and that was a huge relief, because knowing that perhaps there was another child in the water, and as time goes on and you haven't found the person that's missing, it gets more and more unlikely that it's not going to be a happy ending. So the fact that he was found, the police were able to find him, the Honolulu Fire Department was out looking at the various bridges and across Waipahu looking for him, and then you know, our EMS teams responded. So all in all, a harrowing day on Monday, but a great outcome, and we really can't thank him enough. I'd like to call up our district chief, Kenny Faria, who was first on scene for EMS, just to kind of run you through what he saw and kind of what was going through his mind.
Hello, everybody. My name is Kenneth Faria. I'm going to remove my mask as well. I'm the district chief that was on duty that day. I'd like to thank Timothy for his heroic efforts as well. I've been in this department about 16, 17 years, and to enjoy calls like this where the outcome is terrific is just fantastic. Dr. Ireland is correct. The weather was very extreme that day. Responding to the call, the rain was so heavy that we had to drive fairly slow. I arrived on scene for EMS as one of the first units, along with Ever Beach, who followed quickly after. We received the alert that the boy was already out of the water, so we had the Ever Beach crew meet up where Timothy had pulled him out.
Vince.
Sorry, Vince. Timothy is the boy. So where Vince pulled Timothy out, we sent the Ever Beach ambulance there. The scene was so long because it was a canal, so I met up with the battalion chief up at the top by Farrington Highway, and the river was very strong. Just to watch the firemen, the rescue crews operate is very nerve-wracking. The longer someone's in this type of condition in the water, the possibility of the outcome is not that great, so we're happy that he was rescued right away. And in the end, when we found out that HPD found the second boy who was at home, was another positive outcome. But again, I'd like to thank you folks. Thank you, buddy, for your help, and Timothy and his friend for being safe.
So I believe we're going to make a presentation. I just want to add one thing. is that in my former life, being in media for over 40 years, I've done so many stories like this that unfortunately did not have a good ending. And it's always tragic, and again, as Kenny just said, especially when it involves children. So this is really special. It's not just every day. And so we owe a debt of gratitude to you, sir. So if you don't mind, Vince, come on up here. And I'll just read this. It's pretty brief, and this is for you, sir. To Vince Southern, in recognition of his selfless act of valor, in the middle of a powerful storm on January 25th, 2021, he responded to cries for help and managed to rescue a 10-year-old boy from the raging waters of a canal in Waipahu. Mr. Southern jumped into action, pulled the boy to safety, called 911, and left before he could be thanked. He is a hero. He is the epitome of a hero, Vince. Way to go. Congratulations. Thank you. You're good. I could have predicted that he was good. Okay, thank you.
Timothy, however. Timothy
is going to come up here.
Yeah,
right?
You wanted to say a few words, or you still?
We'd like to have you say, come on, Timothy, come on up. This is your moment. I'm so glad you're safe. And this is for you, okay, as well. Here you go, Timothy.
Thank you for helping me and pulling me out of the canal quick as you can. That's it.
That's it.
I have just one more small announcement that there was something else lost in the canal that day, a material possession, but apparently a skateboard was swept away and not to be found again in the raging river. So we at EMS are going to provide our young friend, our young new friend, with a skateboard and a helmet if he doesn't have one for that lost skateboard on that day. Okay, so we're going to get you a skateboard.
Nice.
Okay? All right.
Very good.
Photo.
Yep. We'll take a picture together. Timothy, Vince, we'll take a picture. The painful part's over. The speaking part is over. Jim, Ken, you should be up here. Actually, it should be you four.
Okay.
We're doing shopping.
Oh, sorry.
Get
in here.
Sorry. We have to keep our mask on.
Just as long as you're not in front of us. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. Maybe one with just you two, the boy and Vin.
Okay, one more.
Just one more time, because you can never say thank you enough, especially in a situation like this. First and foremost, to our EMS team, for who you are, what you represent, your ability to come back there. But again, Vince, it all comes back to you in a moment. I don't know what inspired you or anything about you and your background, but you know what? We never know in life until we get into those moments, and you find yourself in one, and you did right. You did the right thing. So tremendous appreciation and gratitude. Thank you for being who you are, man. Thank you. Timothy, good luck.